Aptiv's smart vehicle architecture is an optimized set of technologies that provide all the ingredients for the software-defined vehicle. The hardware architecture, the software architecture, and the ability to use cloud-based tools to develop, deploy, and operate vehicles throughout their life cycle. SVA even lays the groundwork for the next stage in vehicle evolution, its integration as an intelligent edge device and the broader Internet of Things. But where did SVA come from? What makes it innovative? And what makes it so compelling? Let's take a look. Automotive electrical architecture used to be simple. Lighting, audio, power windows and doors. Then OEMs began adding features that required increasingly more complicated electronics, more devices in the vehicle. Radios became infotainment systems. Cruise control became ADAS. Radars and touchscreens became standard equipment. Every feature required its own ECU, its own box. Every device required its own power, its own processing, its own data, and its own connectivity. There were too many boxes, too many wires, and not enough space in the vehicle. In the monolithic approach to software, features couldn't be updated, and software couldn't be easily reused. As the industry headed to new levels of automated driving, this approach wasn't sustainable. Something had to give. As the only technology provider of both the brain and the nervous system of the vehicle, Aptiv saw the challenge clearer than anyone. We brought together experts from around the company, from wiring harnesses and connection systems to software, hardware, and functional safety. And we came up with a solution, Smart Vehicle Architecture, or SVA. SVA has three fundamental principles that set it apart from previous architectures. The first is that SVA separates I/O from compute. Aptiv was ahead of the pack in segmenting electrical architectures into zones, each with a zone controller that delivers power and data connections to the sensors and other nearby devices. Not only does this reduce physical complexity, but the zone controller also abstracts the I/O devices to simplify the interface for higher-level software. The second principle is that SVA abstracts software from hardware. The central vehicle controller, or CVC, handles all communications within the vehicle, coordinating the zone controllers, abstracting body control functions, and translating decisions made by the vehicle brain into actions carried out by the nervous system. The third principle is that SVA serverizes compute. With hardware abstracted, higher-level ADAS software can now focus on making driving decisions, and UX software can focus on improving the in-cabin user experience. The software, running on open server platforms, can use a modern approach to software, containerizing applications into modules that are more quickly and easily updatable. The software-defined vehicle is within reach. Software development can run on its own timeline, independent of hardware development, and OEMs can deliver updates and enhancements to consumers at any time. By the same token, vehicles will collect data for developers, resulting in a digital feedback loop that will improve features over time. In the future, vehicles will become cloud-native, intelligent edge devices that integrate seamlessly with the world around them. With SVA, vehicles will be well prepared for that next stage of their evolution and beyond.